The war in Ukraine is the largest in Europe in 80 years, and is already approaching World War II in terms of the intensity of the fighting. Russia is using its weapons not only on military targets, but also on civilian objects and rear cities with civilians. Therefore, to protect cities, Ukraine badly needs good air defense systems that can shoot down aerial targets with high probability. IRIS-T is one such system. The modern missile system with advanced electronics, according to the Ukrainian Armed Forces officials, shows 100% results of its work. Once again, 100% of air targets detected by IRIS-T system are shot down by it. This is unprecedented efficiency, which is very difficult to achieve. How this is done, we will try to understand it with you today. The infrared imaging system tail thrust, vector controlled, was developed as a replacement for the AIM-9 Sidewinder missile with the ability to launch newer missiles from older carriers. The fact is that the Soviet R-73 missiles, which remained in Germany after reunification, had better performance than the AIM-9. To ensure superiority over Soviet and Russian weapons, European NATO countries in 1996 began development of a new generation missile, which was called IRIS-T. The bulk of the costs were borne by Germany, covering almost 50% of the development costs. The missile was developed by Diehl BGT Defense, GmbH, and Co. KG. IRIS-T was originally a short to medium range air-to-air missile. Since the nomenclature of NATO aircraft is quite broad, it was undesirable to use long-range missiles, as the Soviet military did, because of the risk of mistaking the type of aircraft. F-16, Eurofighter Typhoon, SAAB, Gripen, and Panavia Tornado aircraft were supposed to be used as launch platforms. However, very quickly, the customer countries decided to maximize the use of this missile and ordered the development of a surface-to-surface and sea-launched missile. IDIS is an IRIS-T missile adapted for launch from ships, including submarines. Land-launched versions were developed as a component of NATO's MEADS program, Medium Extended Air Defense System. These missiles received the prefix SL, and there are three types of missiles: SLS, surface-launched short-range, SLM, surface-launched medium-range, and SLX, a surface-launched extended-range. These variants have a range of 12 kilometers, 40 kilometers, and 80 kilometers, respectively, with maximum target altitudes of 12, 20, and 30 kilometers, respectively. SLM was adopted in January 2022. SLX was still in development as of April 2022. Targeting is combined. At launch, the missile uses target designation by target illumination radar and inertial navigation system, the accuracy of which is improved by GPS module. The infrared homing head is activated in the terminal phase of the missile's flight. Speed, up to 3M or 3,672 kilometers per H. The missile has a total mass of 88 kilograms, a length of almost 3 meters, a diameter of only 15.2 centimeters, and a wingspan of 35 centimeters. Nevertheless, such a thin flying match carries a charge of 11.4 kilograms. The fuse is triggered either by direct contact with the target or by the activation of a built-in small active radar. The engine is solid fueled. The design of the missile ensures that it can be aimed at a target in a 360-degree sphere from the launch point and maneuvered with overloads of up to 60 G. In addition to the missiles themselves, the complex includes launchers, target illumination radars, command posts and auxiliary equipment, even the most common trucks that can carry the missiles. The missile is placed in a standard launch container, which is assembled 8 at a time into a block the size of a standard ISO container for transportation by any means of transport, including ships. This unit can then be mounted on any suitable chassis, wheeled or tracked. There are variants of launchers without containers, with rails. Most often, man trucks are used for the platform. 3-axle SX-44 or 4-axle SX-45. There are variants of launchers on the basis of tracked transporters. M113 made in the USA or PMMC-G5 made in Germany. Containerless launchers are designed specifically for IRIS-T missiles on the basis of the Swedish-English BV-410 crawler transporter. IRIS-T is a missile-based system that is guided by an external target illumination radar upon launch. And since the system is international, modularity and variability of detection and targeting systems were taken into account during its development. Therefore, IRIS-T launchers can operate with a very large number of radars, among which Hensoldt, TRML-4D, Groundmaster GM-200MMC, and SAB Giraffe are worth mentioning. The number of simultaneously escorted targets, their detection range, and the number of missiles simultaneously aimed at different targets are different for these radar models. The most interesting is the TRML-4D. This radar can simultaneously track 1,500 targets within a radius of up to 250 kilometers. Together with the radars, command vehicles are used to launch and track missiles. These command vehicles can be located up to 20 kilometers from the launchers and use the most advanced electronics with integrated battle management systems, IBMS. In this way, the entire IRIS-T air defense system becomes a unified system with the rest of the military formations.
As we can see, an air defense missile is not just a piece of cast iron sewer with explosives and a powder engine with welded stabilizers. The high-tech stuffing of the missile itself and the equipment for its launch make it possible to shoot down any helicopters, airplanes, low-flying cruise missiles and UAVs, and to resist IREB means. And although the system is in service in many countries, its first combat use took place in Ukraine in 2022. For reasons of secrecy, there is no information about the real number of IRIS-T complexes, and even less about their location. But nevertheless, officials of the Ukrainian Armed Forces gave information that IRIS-T shot down a Russian cruise missile flying towards Kiev, somewhere in Chernihiv region. Since the system is in service and used almost daily, there is no doubt that it continues to shoot down aerial targets flying at peaceful Ukrainian cities. It was also reported that Russian forces destroyed one of the TRML-4D radars supplied to Ukraine using a Lancet UAV. However, it later turned out that the radar was only slightly damaged and then repaired. So the Russian propaganda is back in the puddle. You won't find video of IRIS-T's operating in Ukraine either for reasons of secrecy, except for a couple of mentions in TV news reports and interviews with fighters who work for them in the air defense forces. The IRIS-T missile has been so successful that it can be used not only against air targets, but also against ground targets. For such use, all that is needed is to modify the software on the missile's payload. This is still an experimental development and has been tested only on the F-16 fighter aircraft, which has onboard target designation means to work on ground targets. Also, open sources have received information that in addition to command centers of the IRIS-T system, Germany provides Ukraine with laser target illumination systems, which are integrated with this system. The question arises, why? After all, the IRIS-T missile at the terminal stage of flight is guided by an infrared guidance head and does not require laser illumination of the target. The question is still open, but we believe that the leadership of the Ukrainian Armed Forces knows better why these laser illumination systems are needed and how to use them. In any case, we expect more Russian flying scrap metal, which will no longer be able to harm people far from the front. The IRIS-T FCAM is a concept for a sixth-generation universal missile based on the current version of the IRIS-T. The hull is supposed to be diamond-shaped to increase speed and reduce effective dispersion area. The engine is likely to be multi-stage, and the control system will incorporate artificial intelligence and machine learning capabilities. So electronic warfare is getting deeper into brutal weapon systems. Germany and a number of other countries have created a truly modern air defense system that effectively protects airspace from uninvited guests. We have to observe the work of this system in real conditions. Unfortunately, because the launching of missile and drone strikes against peaceful cities in the largest European country cannot be justified by anything, neither for military purposes nor for political ones. And fortunately, we can observe the work of IRIS-T because it has already saved the lives of many thousands, if not tens of thousands, of people in Ukraine. Without such systems, the number of civilian casualties, including children, would be disproportionately higher. Well, let's wish the guys working on IRIS to work their targets without missing a beat, and we hope that soon the attacks on Ukraine will stop. Russia must answer for all the destruction it has caused.